right. Thanks for checking out the Classify Numbers video for MathCelebrity.com. My name is Don Subsick, founder of MathCelebrity, and today I'm going to show you how to determine if a number is natural, rational, an integer, or irrational. And in today's video, I'm going to show you the tests you can perform, either positive or negative, whichever you prefer, on how to determine these number properties. So if that sounds good, let's go get it. So we've got the four types of numbers: natural, rational, integers, and irrational. Let's go ahead and start with a natural number test. So let's say you're given some number n, and we want to know, is this number natural? Well, first, it helps to know the properties of natural numbers. They are positive counting numbers, and they exclude zero. So think of a number line, where you have whole numbers and a little tick marks. Start at 1 to the right of 0 and keep going, and all of those are natural numbers. And so if you want to write it in set notation, we can read this as x such that x is greater than 0, and it's 1, 2, 3, and then the infinity notation. The special symbol for natural numbers is this n, so that tells you that 1, 2, 3, and so on is a natural number. Now, I'm a big fan of shortcuts and laziness and speed. So sometimes it helps me, and I know a few other people, to do, instead of positive test to see if something is, I look for disqualification tests to see if it isn't. So for example, let's say I want to know if a number is natural or not. Well, here's some quick disqualification tests I can perform to say, no, it's not natural. Is it negative? Then it's not natural. Is there a decimal? It's not natural. Is there a square root? Then it's not natural. And of course, is it zero? Then it's not natural. And if you want to move quickly, and this is how some detectives work in police cases, sometimes they try to eliminate the negatives or test for the negatives because that moves the test faster. So you pick however you like to test, but I want to show you both methods. Now let's move to rational numbers. So rational numbers are numbers which can be represented as A over B or A divided by B, where both A and B are integers and B is not equal to zero. We denote this using the R sign with the double lines, so that denotes rational numbers. So an example, of course, is 1, 2, 3, but they can also be negative as well. Now, let's talk about disqualification tests. So first, is it a repeating fraction or an imaginary number? Then it's not rational. So those are some quick checks, like the number I, which is the square root of negative 1, that you can perform to move quickly and say, you know what, this number is not rational. Next, let's do the integer test. So integers are positive and negative whole numbers, not decimals. So we've got the set notation here, x such that x is a negative or positive integer, including zero. We denote this with this special z symbol to tell you that, yes, this is the set of integers. If you're interested in disqualifying to determine that a number is not an integer, then ask yourself these three questions. Is it a decimal? Then it's not an integer. Is it a square root or a root of a number? Then it's not an integer. And of course, is it imaginary? Then it's not an integer. So that's how you know to disqualify on the integer test. And then the fourth test for classifying numbers is a number irrational? I strongly suggest you do the negative test instead of trying to evaluate. Ask yourself this question: if a number's rational, an integer or a natural, and really all three of those combine into irrational, then it's not irrational. So you could tell instantly when you're doing the test on rationality, if a number is rational, then it's not irrational. So it's the opposite of rational. All right, so I put together this little grid for you. These are testing scenarios, and I've listed both the positive tests and the negative tests, because once again, everybody's different. So you could use these tests, which I've just summarized in the grid from our previous four slides, on how to test for or against a number classification type. So we've got natural, rational, integer, and irrational. And notice the positive test for irrational is really the negative test for irrational. So you're seeing whether or not a number is rational. And then if it's an irrational, that's the opposite of the rational. So finally, calculator demo time. If you're on our site right now, MathCelebrity, and you're watching this video, you're already on the Classify Numbers calculator. If you're on our homepage or a different lesson, or you're coming straight from YouTube and you want to know what to do, I'm going to give you the quick demo right now. So first, I've studied for the last 11 years how people ask for these problems, and generally they're in this format. People ask, our type, is 25 rational, is 45 an integer, is 34.5 natural, etc., etc. So we're going to run two of those tests right now. So we'll say, is 28 a natural number? And so the search engine routes us to the classification of numbers calculator. As you can see, we're running the four tests. We asked the calculator for natural numbers. So I do all four tests for you. You could scroll and see whichever test you need to look at. But here's the natural number test. And remember, we covered in our presentation, a number is natural if it was one of the counting numbers greater than zero. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Well, since 28 is positive and it's one of the counting numbers, 28 is indeed a natural number. And what the calculator does is it'll test for the four properties. And when it's done, it will list out for you every property that it meets. So if it doesn't meet a property, you won't see it here in the summary. So let's do one more. We'll say, is 34.6 a rational number? And again, the calculator routes us to the classification of numbers test. It's going to run through here. And it does the natural number test, and of course that fails because it's a decimal. It's going to run the integer test. It fails because it's a decimal. Now we're at the rational number test. Because you can express this as A over B, so let's say really this is 346 divided by 10, that's one rational test, then yes, this number is indeed rational. And the beauty of this is, this calculator runs the negative test. And it says, since 34.6 is a rational number from above, therefore 34.6 is not an irrational number. So as you can see, we ran four tests that passed only one, the rational test. So that concludes the presentation. You've learned how to do the positive and negative test for the four classification types, and I've shown you the demo of the calculator. Once again, I want to thank you for spending time with me and learning about these tests. I'll see you in the next video.